What's poppin', y'all? It's your girl Princess Tommy, and I'm back today with a brand new video. I will always ask you, they gonna be forever be ashy. At this point, I don't even care. But today is Tuesday, and you already know what that means. Girl talk. Today's episode on Girl Talk with Tommy, we will be talking about taking care of your hair. This hair for today, okay? Because y'all know, like I said, we have too many segments to talk about a female's life than just to discuss it all in one video. So, this will just be about how to take care of your hair and keep your hair healthy. And I will also be telling y'all how I grew back my hair. If you've been following me for a long time, y'all know, like, my hair wasn't the length that it is now, especially since I cut my hair. Like, I had literally all of this side of my hair gone. I have a few products with me, so I'm going to be showing you guys them, you know, just one by one. First thing that I want to start off with is scissors. Like, everyone's gonna have dead ends. You may think them dead ends is cute for the length of your hair, but in reality it's not. It's stopping your hair from growing and getting past the length that you want it to be. Cause my ends is all split and messy and long. Baby, when I had my trim, they was like snip, 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 and all of it was gone. So to avoid having that big chop in your ends, you just might as well wanna clip your ends at least every 3 months. Trim your ends at least. Cutting your hair is very important. You don't always have to do it, but it's a very good thing. When I shaved my hair off, like the new hair that came in, it was so much better than the hair that was already there because it was new hair. And when you cut your hair always grows back better than what it was before. Trimming your ends and trimming your hair in general is so important. I had heat damage, y'all, so bad. Like, I had heat damage in the front part of my hair. Not too long ago, and it was so bad that I cut it. Like, I cut it myself. I cut it so much. And then, like, when I had went to flat out my hair, I had, like a little bang right here. And it was so ugly. Like, but it grew back. It did grow back. It took some time to grow back, but it grew back and it was healthy. Sometimes you might gotta cut off too much of your hair to grow back the good hair. And it's a process that people who want to have healthier hair should take. People who've been doing like the big chop, they want to start all over and grow new hair. And I've seen people go from their hair to like right here to they rocking these big old curly bushes. And it's just so bomb. If I had the heart to cut all my hair off and start over, I would do it. However, I would not be doing it because I don't have the heart for that. Clip your ends. Your hair grows at the roots, y'all. Remember that. It doesn't grow at the bottom of your hair. It grows at the roots. So once your hair starts growing and growing and growing, it's going to be like this big old patch right here, and then your ends are going to be looking really bad. A lot of people, when they wash their hair, they use any kind of shampoo and they use any kind of conditioner. And a lot of shampoo and conditioner contains chemicals that it's not good for your hair. This is my conditioner that I use. This one is Africa's Best. The deep conditioner, y'all, this is so bomb. It makes your hair so smooth. The curls be defined. Like, it's easy to comb through. And I just started using this because, like, you're not gonna always know what conditioner and stuff to use as you're transitioning to this stage. If you're getting ready to start this bringing your hair back to life stage, I do recommend Africa's Best Rinse Out and Leave In Deep Conditioner, so you can leave it in or you can rinse it out. I also have this one, which is the Whole Blends Replenishing Conditioner. I have the shampoo to match that. One thing I can say about this one is it leaves your hair like really oily, but it is good for your hair. But my favorite one is this one. This is why I recommended y'all to get this one. You can find these things at your local beauty supply store. Not sponsored, but you know, go get it anyway. To apply conditioner, you mainly want to apply it to your end. The ends are the weakest part of your hair. Everything happens to the end, so you have to treat your ends like they're a newborn baby. Put the most conditioner on your ends. You'll thank me later. Everybody wondering how I grew my hair? You'll thank me later. condition your ends, baby. A lot, like a lot. You're gonna have some bomb growth. Here is the shampoo that I use. It's the same kind as the conditioner. It restores softness and it restores shine. They have many different conditioners for like color damage or end damage. They have so many buys. So it's all about trying new things and reading the back of conditioners, because you think that the chemicals in the conditioner are really good for your hair and they're not. So you have to be willing to actually read all the back of stuff to know which is good for your hair and what's not. Again, everything isn't going to be good for everybody. So this may work for me and it may not work for y'all. Like, I just started using this too. I used to use Pantene. I used to use Cantu. And Cantu is not good for your hair. So it's not good for my hair. It doesn't work for my hair. It leaves my hair flaky and all that other stuff. Like, no. What I decided to do to, you know, get the length back in my hair, I didn't use to weave, y'all. I didn't start wearing weave until the 8th grade. I had my first pair of Molly twists. And I used to think that if I put braids in my hair would break off. So I never had fake braids. I never had weave or any of that. I just started getting weave in the 8th grade. So after I got my first pair of twists or whatever, my hair grew. I know a lot of people may say, I don't want to put weave in my hair because it messes your hair up and blah, blah, blah. No. Weaves are protective styles for a reason. Honestly, in my opinion, you taking care of your natural hair more, like you doing all these twist outs and braid outs and adding all these gels and all this curly hair products to your hair, and you mixing all that together in your hair, is damaging your hair. Girl, get some braids and keep it pushing. Your hair's gonna grow. Why? Because you have weave wrapped up protecting your real hair, so your real hair doesn't get damaged. So whenever you come across a YouTube video and someone's saying, oh, taking my braids out, you'll grow. Yeah, they don't be capped. Their hair really be growing like that because you're not touching your real hair, so nothing can happen to it. Yeah, wearing your hair natural and stuff is good, but it's okay to get braids. Like, it's going to make your hair grow as well as weave. Like, tracks, I just sneeze, y'all. When I get leave out, I didn't think I would ever get heat damage. I did. So now I'm in the process of fixing that. I moved on to closures. And after that, cornrow on my hair, it trains your hair to get back to that curly method. Whenever someone said, I'm trying to get my curly hair back, blah, 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 I'm just going to do natural styles and this, and that, you should want to start training your hair to curl. Cornrowing your hair is going to train your hair to curl. You can start training your hair by cornrowing it, and you can add a little flexi rod to it to get the curl. You can train your hair to get back to that curling stage. Trust me, I've done it before. And you won't even think that I probably damaged or not, because I've made it work. Like, I'm training my hair to get back to the curly method. So again, like I said, you can wear the ponytail, you can wear the slick back, you can do all of this and all that. So whenever someone's saying, why you got on and leaving your hair, I bet you they're bald headed. So next, I got these braids in. They didn't last very long, but it's protecting my hair. So I didn't know what to do with my natural hair, because my natural hair is a lot too tame. That's why I don't really, you know, wear it out. When y'all be asking me, why you don't wear your natural hair? Because it's a lot of work. I don't want to add no unnecessary products to my hair that I don't need. My hair is naturally curly, so I don't need no curl moisture, no all that other stuff. Heat. Cut out heat. I'm not even gonna copy, y'all. I haven't been heatless like that for real, because the blow dryer counts. So whenever someone says, yeah, I've been heatless for this long, the blow dryer counts, unless you blow dry your hair on cool air. If you're gonna cut out heat, that means flat iron, hot comb, blow dryer, under dryer, all that stuff. So I do recommend cutting out a little bit of heat. I'm not gonna tell you yet, cut out heat completely, because I don't do that. Yeah, and every time I get a closure, like the front part of my hair, it gets cornrowed. So it's getting trained to curl, like I said. Detangling. Whenever you tangle your hair, don't use a rat tail comb. I don't have one on me. Always use a wig brush or a paddle brush, whatever you want to call it, to comb out your hair. You comb out your hair, you always want to start from the ends. Start from the ends and work your way up. So when you get to your roots, it's just straightforward. And don't just brush it while it's all over the place. No. Part your hair in like at least 4 different parts. Start from the back, cornrow it. Go to the next one, cornrow it. Sleep like that. Wake up the next morning and do whatever you gotta do to your hair. I used to treat my hair like crap, and that's what I got, crappy hair. So when you do crappy things, you get crappy results. I started taking care of my hair, I got some good, pretty results. And I'm gonna show you, I'm not capping. I'm gonna have some pictures in here, and I'm gonna show y'all how bad my hair was. Coconut oil. Personally, I have a very dry scalp. So, I can grease my hair like today, and it'll be dry by Friday. I don't really know why. But I always tend to do a hot oil treatment because it lasts longer. You would put this in like a bowl or something, you can microwave it, put it on the stove. And while your hair is dirty, put it in your hair, let it sit for a few hours, you rinse it out. Your hair will be greased. Hot oil treatments are very important to your hair, and I do recommend them to everyone instead of just greasing your scalp. Hot oil treatment, it lasts longer and it feels much better. You can use any kind of oil that you think is good for your hair. I use the coconut oil. This is the only one I have right now on me. But I use the coconut oil, the black seed oil, and I do use shea butter. And what I do is I mix it all up, I put it in a bowl, put it on the stove in a little big old pot. Let it sit. After it sit, I'll put that all in my scalp, girl. And I'm good to go. I made it up, y'all. So that's my secret. Don't tell them what my secret. This is my last product that I want to show you guys. And it is the Aztec Healing Clay Mask. It's also for your face. So it's good for your skin. And it's good for your hair as well. I tried this on my hair one time. Bomb. Curls was bomb. Like, my curls was never like that before. Them days was sharp and big, and it was just giving you like Erica Badu type vibe. I was like, yes, go off, queen. Ever want like some good curls and stuff? This is the one for you, baby. These are the things on how to keep your hair healthy, baby girl. If you missed a tip, scroll back. Everybody hair different. Everybody hair responds to different things. But yeah, that's all I gotta say to y'all for today. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video on how to take care of your hair, how I grew my hair back in as well, how to keep your hair healthy. I will see y'all next Tuesday with another Girl Talk. If you're not subscribed to my channel, click that subscribe button right now. Also, with the bell so you'll be notified when I post a new video. If you're new to my channel, what's up, y'all? It's your girl, Princess Tommy. And that's me. And I post on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Sundays. I didn't post last Sunday because my computer was acting like a retard. So a video didn't go up. You know, it's cool. It's all cool in the hood because y'all understand me. I understand y'all. So we just cool like that. But you know, yeah, subscribe, join the family. Hope y'all love me or whatever because I love y'all. And that's the dad on the net. Period. And I'll see y'all in the next video.